I'm Andrea D'Ambrogio. I'm layout manager of E-Team Squadra Corse of University of Pisa. Last year we received the Prusa i3 Mark 3S Plus, and we used a lot this kind of 3D printer. For example, we printed the paddles for gear shift on the steering wheel. We also designed using a 3D scanner. We used the 3D printer for realize the handle on the steering, the same steering wheel. But we also used the Prusa 3D printer for a lot of supports or spacers, which are set on the car. Now we can see how the Prusa slicer is used for export the G-code. I personally think that it's one of the most useful and easy to understand software on the net. It's also free, and it allows you to use a lot of different infills, patterns and settings that you can customize as you want. So we choose to keep this kind of slicer, because we think, obviously, that's the best for this kind of 3D printer. Actually, we are printing the paddles for the new steering wheel. We are only printing a test this year. In fact, we are shifting from an internal combustion engine to an electric vehicle. So probably we won't need a paddle for the gear shift, but we are also testing a different infill to understand how we can, for example, use the same of the paddles for regenerative braking, for example. We have two vehicles, a combustion one and a driverless one. This is the steering wheel of the first one, so the combustion car. We have printed the paddles of the gear shift. So these are the supports and these are the paddles. And here we have the mask of the steering wheel. Background, we can see that Prusa has just finished the new paddles. This is the other steering wheel. Instead of the driverless car is without driver, it needs anyway a steering wheel, because it must be controlled by a driver if it is an accessory. We have printed the handle, and we can see the geometry, which is different, totally different from the other geometry, so from the easy geometry of paddles of the combustion vehicle. We have studied using 3D scanners the geometry of the end of our drivers, and we are going to print the backside of the handle in the right way for the right hand of the driver. So here we have the PC box for the autonomous vehicle. Outside we can see a 3D printed box for the electrical boards, and inside there are a lot of supports for the GPU to other supports, for example motherboard supports, which are stuck inside. Maybe this is one of the most difficult devices to design, because there are a lot of components, one near to the other, and they are many difficult to cool. And we can see here on the right a fan cover to avoid that water goes inside of the box. This was also 3D printed with Prusa. And this other mask for cover the PC box from the water. Recently we performed a tensile test on our materials. So we tested the PETG, carbon nylon, PLA, ABS, in order to understand which were the mechanical properties of these materials. And this year we are going to use more than past year these kind of materials, because now we know them better, and we are going to use them for maybe for structural systems and devices. So we are going to improve our production in terms of 3D printing. So after this test, I'm really excited to see these new materials printed with Prusa on the new car for the season 2023.